It was Lynmouth's picturesque location at the convergence of two rivers flowing down from Exmoor to the Devon coast that in the end spelt its destruction. The East and West Lyn that meet beneath the bridge had always been part of the appeal of the little village. On the night of August 15th, 1952, swollen by the heaviest cloudburst in living memory, 60 million tons of water swept down the river's bed, engulfing all in its path.
Under the sudden influx of torrential rain, the West Lyn River, which normally flows quietly through Lynmouth to the sea, changed its course, ploughing a path of destruction through the sleeping valley. 10 bridges were swept away, while huge boulders, uprooted by the swelling waters, rained upon the houses in an orgy of destruction.
I think perhaps it looked a bit like Hiroshima. It would have probably been hit by an atom bomb. There were mountains of mud and stone and wood, and houses and shops that we know either washed away or in little bits and pieces.
Lynmouth boasted a small fishing fleet. All its vessels were swept out to sea and lost. Ken Oxenham saw his livelihood vanish from sight.
I'm one of the local fishermen here. I'm afraid the storm's taken all our boats away.
66 motor cars went down the river, their lights on, short-circuited and blazing as they turned over and over a few times. That you could see in the darkness.
At the cemetery at the foot of Holiday Hill a week later, Lynmouth buried its dead. 35 people perished in the flood, some of them swept out to sea, their bodies never recovered.
Forty-five years after the Lynmouth flood disaster, they're looking again at the causes of the flash flood that claimed so many lives. Was it just a freak of nature, or perhaps